parent telling you to do that which is right in the sight of the Lord, you better listen.
Yes.
Better be obedient.
Yes.
Do what they tell you to do. And it's not hard.
Amen.
When I started looking back at some stuff that my mama told me to do, I said it really wasn't that bad. I don't know why I was putting up a fuss and fight about it. It really wasn't that bad. But I noticed that they were protecting us.
Amen.
They were keeping us. Because they knew some stuff that we did not know. That's what I'm telling y'all. Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yes.
It's better to be obedient.
Yes.
Than to buck up and gotta pay the price.
Yes.
I remember my grandmother, widow, she fussed and she hooped and hollered all about the movie theaters. Oh, don't go to the movies. Oh, no, you know, them preachers preach no movie house and they preaching on it. Oh, don't go there. And they used to keep us and we bucked up. Oh, we going to the movies anyway. What's wrong with going to the movies? And I ain't formulating no doctrine, but I'm just testifying. But oh, we ain't going to no movies and nothing. Oh, we going anyway. So we went. And y'all know we started getting into some trouble. And they were not necessarily saying it because it was not right within its nature. But they knew some stuff could happen out of the presence of the parents. They knew what went on in places like that. Nowadays, now I hear about shooters in the movie theaters and folks running right in the movie theater, blowing folks' brains out. And I say, Lord, I don't want to step foot nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't want to be fearful and can't move, but at the same time, Lord, if I'm sitting up in there and somebody come in and shoot up everybody, I don't want to be found in that number.
That's right.
I don't want to be destroyed with the wicked.
That's right.
Yeah, so sometimes you got to refrain from stuff just because.
That's right.
Sometimes they ain't that deep. Sometimes the people of God can't go places just because.
That's right. Amen.
Because you can be found in the wrong place at the wrong time.
That's right.
So sometimes we got to use wisdom. And sometimes we just got to do it just because. And we ain't got to buck up against it. We just say, yes, mama. Yes, daddy. And the next thing we know, a few weeks later, we hear about something tragic happened in the same place you wanted to go to. And then we say, thank God, because I almost went there. It could have been me in that number. So sometimes we got to listen. And sometimes our parents will allow us to do things. Sometimes they will allow us. But this one particular night, they say, I don't think it's best for you to go. Don't buckle. Well, I want to go. You let me go any other time. Just listen.
Amen.
Because sometimes the Holy Ghost can be giving them a feeling that something might be getting ready to happen. I don't know what it is, but tonight I think we just don't need to go.
Right.
Here on the news, such and such a thing happened. And then you go back and say, thank God, the Lord will lead my parents to keep me from this and that. Do y'all know it is not the things that we know God brought us from that we're going to be praising God about? Do y'all know that? We know about the stuff God has done, but what about that stuff that you don't know nothing about? That stuff that the Lord is going to allow us to see that he was keeping us from that we had no clue about. Walking around the corners and driving out of cars at night and the Holy Ghost tell you, don't go down that street. Go down this street. Don't go that way. Go this way. Don't go today. Stay home. We gotta be obedient to the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Because sometimes the Lord is keeping us from evil, keeping us from danger.
Yes.
And we don't know what it was. But one day in glory, when the Lord started telling us and revealing things to us that we could not see. Remember when you was getting ready to go here that night? Well, you didn't hear about it, but this is what happened. Remember you was about to take that road and I led you to go the other way? See, this is why I led you. There was some crazy folks lurking. Because y'all know we have some wicked people that want to kill people for no reason. For no reason whatsoever. They're just wicked. I just want to kill somebody today. That spirit getting them people just want to kill somebody today. And you may just be that innocent victim that was walking down that road at the wrong time. And he saw you. And you was his lunch for the night.
Yes.
Just because he's wicked.
Yeah.
The type of world we're dealing with a perverted and wicked world that don't care about nobody and nothing. We done heard the news. You go right and sit in a church, a place of worship, and sit for an hour throughout the whole Bible study. Out of the whole prayer, hearing the name of the Lord Jesus. I don't care whether it was in the truth or not. You was hearing about Jesus. Mm-hmm. That should have convicted and pricked your heart to stop doing what you was about to do. You hear them talk about the Lord and the goodness of God, and that wicked heart would sit there and wait till they was done all that. And boom, boom, boom. Destroy them all. We're living in a world with wicked people that don't care. It ain't none of us exempt from anything. It's by the grace and the mercy of God. So some of y'all might as well get out yourself and stop taking it's you. It's by the grace and the mercy of God. You don't look that good. You ain't that cute. You don't dress that nice. It's by the goodness of God. You ain't got that much money. Because I guarantee somebody let that body start wrecking with pain and some illness getting that body that money can't buy a cure for. And you won't know your money ain't got you here. Your looks didn't get you here. And I don't care how good you sing or how well you preach, it didn't get you here. It's by the grace and the mercy of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Were there not 10? Yeah, we educated. We thank God for college and higher levels of education and learning. But our degrees don't make us who we are.
Amen.
That's why I never can understand how folk can start getting things in life and stick their nose up at folk. I come from a different grain. The more I get, the more I know, the more I humble myself. The more I want to say, Lord, keep revealing yourself to me. Lord, keep doing what you're doing. It causes me to remember where he's brought me from. And the Apostle Paul said, I count it all as dung anyway. I count it as nothing. When it compares to where God is about to take me, everything I accumulate is nothing. I don't care if I had 10 bedroom house and 5 bathrooms and a 5-car garage and all that foolishness. One day it's all going to be burnt up anyway.
Amen.
It's all going to be destroyed sooner or later. So we can't get caught up in the things that we possess to think it makes us. It's by the grace and the mercy of God that we're not that homeless person laying out on the street. By the grace and the mercy of God that we're not that drug addict with that needle in that vein. It's by the grace and the mercy of God. Sometimes, Lord, have mercy on our souls. Sometimes the Lord cleans us up and fixes us up so nice, and we walk past that drunkard, and we walk past that drug addict, and we look at them as if, oh, they're crazy, something wrong with them. But one day you, that same alcoholic, that same druggie, you were the same one. And God has no respect of a person. If God did it for you, he can do it for them. If God brought you out, he can bring them out. That's why we as a church folks gonna start coming out. That's why, look, I'm warning you. There's gonna be folks that's gonna come in here that don't look like you look. Don't talk like you talk. Don't dress like we dress. We gotta be careful how we treat them. We gotta be careful how we look at them. Because even though you don't say it out of your mouth, you can give folks a look.
Mm-hmm.
A look that'll kill them. That's why we gotta be careful what we do. You looking at them up and down and you, who they think they are. You ain't got to say nothing out your mouth. Your look said it all. Sometimes you ain't got to say nothing out your mouth. The way you look at people, the way you treat people, it says it all.
Mm-hmm.
You'll be a body language.
That's
yeah, you know that's why they call it body language.
That's right.
Because even though you don't say nothing out your mouth, it's still speaking. Oh yeah, it's still speaking. That's why I know when some of y'all got a nasty attitude coming in here.
Mm-hmm.
I see it by your body language. You ain't got to say it out your mouth, but when you're sitting there looking, I know you got an attitude. And whatever you got an attitude for, you might as well get over it. Whatever it is, get over it. And have a good time in the Lord. Let the Holy Ghost work on it.
Thank
you ain't got to speak everything your body's speaking for you.
Amen.
praise God, and you think somebody can that you got an attitude. I don't know about nobody else, but I could care less. I could care less how you look. I could care less what your body's saying. I'm gonna praise God anyhow. You might as well get over it. Praise the name of our God. Because I don't know about nobody else. This is the house of God. What's the name of this church? The whole true church of the Lord Jesus. This is the Lord's church. Amen. This is the house of God. This ain't your church. Praise God. This ain't your church. Praise God. It's the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. And whatever the Lord wants to do, the Lord's going to do it. Not without your approval. Praise the name of our God. Whether you like it or not, the Lord going to do what he manifests, and he going to do it.
That's right. That's
whether
right.
you like it or not. That's so you right. might as well humble yourself, put your seatbelt on, and go for the ride. You might as well do it. Because it's the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. And whatever the Lord say, we going to do what the Lord say to do. We gotta be mindful of what the Lord is doing. And we gotta be grateful for what the Lord is doing. Because God has been good to us. God has been mighty good to us. And I don't wanna be in the number of the nine. I wanna be just that one. That'll turn around and give God the glory. That'll bow down and worship him. I don't know about y'all, but I want to be lost in the presence of God. I want to feel God. I want to know God is here. Praise the name of our God. Lord, don't just come by here, but Lord, rest here. Rule here. The preachers under the authority of God. Praise the name of our God. I ain't got no church. There's a parish ain't got no church. It's the church of the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Whatever the Lord says is not going to be done. Praise the name of our God. Even the preacher himself got to be subject to the power of God.
Thank you, Lord.
The preacher got to follow the instruction of God. The preacher can't do nothing on willy-nilly on his own accord.
That's right. Amen.
The preacher got to lay before God and say, Lord, whatever you say, yes, Lord. Yes. Now, how are you going to work something that don't belong to God?
That's it.
And I just heard not only the brothers, not the sisters neither.
That's right.
Praise the name of our God.
That's
if the
right.
brothers can't do it, the sisters definitely can't do it.
That's it.
You can't say you don't believe in women preachers,
that's
but you're trying to run the church
that's
on the pier.
Right.
Thank you, Jesus. Tell it true. Tell it true.
This is the kind of preacher y'all like, don't you?
Yes.
Tell it true.
A woman to teach. Neither. Some of y'all caught up on preaching, but there's another part to it. Neither you shall depart.
Hallelujah!
I ain't gonna let that spirit run rampant in the church. Because if we let that spirit run rampant in the church, it'll affect the whole body. And I don't know about y'all, but I'm a defender of the church of the living God. And if you defend the rise his head up against the wisdom and the knowledge of God, it's about to be torn down. So the knowledge will fuck him up and go along with the lie. Praise the name of our God. Because the preacher don't run the church.
Thank you,
the
Jesus.
The brothers don't run the church.
That's right.
The women don't run the church.
That's right.
The Lord Jesus Christ runs the church.
Amen.
You might as well humble